Hello everyone, myself Kiran Sakre. I am from CodeVision engineering team. In this demo, I'll showcase configuring iOS with CodeVision 10. Before configuring iOS with CodeVision 10, you need to enable few options at the iOS. These options you can locate in the application development features. The options needs to be enabled are ASP, CGI, ISCP extensions and ISCP filter. Once you enable this option, you can configure iOS with CodeVision in two mode: during installation or using the wsconfig tool. You can locate the wsconfig tool in CVision runtime bin folder. Once you open the wsconfig tool, you will have an option to add the connector. Once I select the add option in the wsconfig tool, you will see the configurations. The first configuration in this is application host. This tells you where your server is running. If you are configuring the connector with the server which are in the same machine, you need to provide the host name of the machine. For this configuration, I'm telling it's a local host. If your server is in a remote machine, you need to give the host of the remote machine. Next configuration is a cluster. This drop down lists you all the clusters that you created in the CodeVision. Next property is a web server. This option allows you to select the connector that you want to configure. As I'm configuring IIS, I'll select the IIS. The next option, next configuration is websites. This lists you all the websites. Because I'm configuring for all the sites, I'll select the all site. Next configuration is a configure 32-bit web server. This option needs to be enabled when you are configuring a site which is running in 32-bit application pool. Once you select the advanced option, you will see verbose logging enable. This option needs to be enabled when you are trying to generate the verbose logging for all the requests. This needs to be used only during debugging purpose, should not be enabled in the production. Enable buffering is another option which by default enabled. This allows IIS to buffer the response. Eventually it has a performance gain, but CFflush, if your application uses a CFflush, this option needs to be disabled. Other configurations are connection pool configurations. This here we have something called reuse connections. It is set to 250. This needs to be tuned based on your load on your server. There is also idle connections, which is by default disabled. This also needs to be tuned based on your load on your server. Once you configure the IIS with CodeVision, CodeVision will generate connector files. These connector files can be located in CodeVision home directory, config, wsconfig folder. These are the connector files. The first file is isaparedir.dll. This is a connector file which will be loaded in the IIS. Next file is isaparedir.log file. This is a log file where all the verbose logs are generated. isaparedir.property file. This contains the connector configuration properties like log file path and the connector path. uriworker.property file is another configuration file. In this, it stores all the file extensions and the mappings that CodeVision handles. Similarly, there is one more file called worker.property file. This contains information about the worker which handles the CodeVision request. Here, CFusion is a worker which handles the request, and it has the properties like type, host, port, and the max reuse connection. Even similarly, this configuration is applicable for standalone. For cluster setting, this worker.list contains all the workers that will be talking to the multiple servers. Now we will go to the IIS where all the configuration changes are done by the IIS configuration tool. The first change it does is adds a connector module into the ISAP CGI restrictions. This is the connector entry made into the ISAP CGI restrictions. Once you configure, each website will have a virtual directory created. Because I configure for all the site will have a virtual directory created. See, the CFID and the Jakarta are the two virtual directory which are created. The Jakarta is a pointing to the folder where all the connector files are placed. Similarly, IIS configuration also adds a mappings which tells you which are the file extension needs to be handled by the connector. Like CFM, CFCs, these are the file extension that CodeVision connector handles. Along with that, it also adds a ISAP filter entry, which tells you this is a ISAP module which handles a CodeVision request. That is all for this demo. Thank you for listening.